morning, good afternoon, good evening. Hi, this is Dr. Dabosky. Welcome back to another fun-filled video lecture. So this will deal with Module 2, Chapter 7. I'm going to first introduce you to the new sight words and the additional mnemonics that you could use to help study and remember the key content for long-term assets. Following this video, I'll record another session that will deal with the depreciation methods, dealing with more of the technical aspects of depreciation, with a special concentration on straight line depreciation and double declining balance methods. That will be following up from this video. I hope you're enjoying the course so far. So let's get right into these new mnemonics from Chapter 7. And again, this is Module 2. So if you'll follow along here, these are just my notes. I'm just going to review some key concepts. I recommend that you try to understand these concepts. And anything that I give you as a calculation or a formula, it's kind of something you kind of have to understand in order to do the proper calculations for depreciation. But overall, depreciation is a pretty doable topic. You should stay confident and work your way through it by the readings, watching these short videos, and doing any homework that I've assigned. So here we go. So let's move on down to what depreciation is. So depreciation is a systematic and rational allocation, okay? A systematic and rational allocation of the purchase price of a long-term asset over its economic useful life. So that's kind of the definition of what depreciation. So notice there's some key words here. Number one is that it's systematic and it's a rational, and the key word is allocation. And what do we allocate? We allocate the purchase price of what we paid for this long-term asset. Exactly what goes into the purchase price, we're going to discuss in my next video, and I have an example too to show you how we determine that. But the primary focus is that anything that readies the asset for its intended use and general purpose are generally capitalized. And capitalized is an important term, and I'm going to write this in now. What does it mean to capitalize a cost? Oh, I heard someone say it. You're correct. We add it to the balance sheet. Okay. The opposite of capitalizing a cost is to expense it on the income statement. So whenever you hear the word capitalize, I want you to think that it's added to the balance sheet. So that's your really key terminology that you need to be familiar with, is that we add it to the balance sheet. Okay? So now let's get into some key terms. So depreciable base. What is depreciable base? Depreciable base is the cost minus the residual value, okay? And residual value, sorry for my bad typing today, residual value is an estimate of the asset's cost at the end, or the asset's worth at the end of its useful life. It's an estimate. So again, who makes this estimate? Management does. So be aware that this is an estimate and it's made by management, okay? So it's an estimate. Okay? So that's residual value. Once you know the depreciable base, right, your cost will be whatever it's given to you in a problem. The residual value will be given to you. Subtract the residual value from the cost and you'll have the depreciable base. If you take the if you want to know the depreciation rate, then you need to take, the formula is 1 over the life in years. And it turns out to be a percentage when you do that division. So if it's a 5-year property, an example, if it's 5-year property, the useful life would be 1/5 or 20% per year. Okay? Once you know the depreciation rate, you then can calculate the depreciation expense, which will be equal to the depreciable base, which we calculated up above, cost minus residual, times the depreciation rate, which is 1 over the life in years, will give you your depreciation expense. So now, once you have your depreciation expense, let's look at what are the three methods. So here's my little mnemonic for this topic. I want you to think of this as a very sad topic. Can everyone make a sad face? Yes, it's very sad. Matter of fact, the three main methods of depreciation spell the word sad. They are straight line, activity based, and declining balance. Notice the S, the A, and the D. And since it's a sad topic because it has to deal with death. Unfortunately, death is a very sad topic. And the one physical journal entry that we have to record for depreciation expense is that we have to debit depreciation expense and credit another contra asset. Remember in a prior video, we learned about the allowance for uncollectible accounts, which was a contra asset to accounts receivable. This is another contra asset called accumulated depreciation. And it's where we store all of the depreciation over time. And it resides on the balance sheet. So it's a permanent, it's a PAL, it's a permanent account. We never zero out that balance. Any given time, the accumulated depreciation will tell you how much of the asset has been depreciated since you put the asset into use in your business. You'll notice the entry, notice the debit account's always on top, the credit account's on the bottom. This follows the standard form of journal entries. Notice depreciation expense, D. E and accumulated depreciation A D. What does that spell? DEAD. Correct. Dead. Sad topic. So if you're not sure how to record depreciation expense and what are the entries, matter of fact, your accounting cycle project has several entries where you have to record this exact same entry, and they just give you the depreciation expense. So you debit depreciation expense, you credit the contra asset accumulated depreciation, and you're done. Finally, the last term that you'll need to be familiar with in this topic is called book value, also known as the net asset value. And book value is equal to cost minus accumulated depreciation, which we just discussed what that is. That difference will be referred to as what we call book value. Well, that's a quick introduction to the key terminology for this topic. Please make sure that in Module 2, Chapter 7, you're familiar with depreciation. What does it mean to capitalize a cost? What is the depreciable base? What is residual value? How do you calculate the depreciation rate? What is the depreciable base? How do you determine the depreciation expense? What are the methods of depreciation? What is the journal entry for depreciation expense? And what is the book value of an asset? How is it measured? And that is all the stuff that's in this short little document. I hope you've enjoyed this. This concludes this video.